So your boss has tasked you with building an application that can run directly in the browser, but also that can run directly from the desktop. Well, what are you going to do? You're not going to be able to use ASP.NET in that scenario. And maybe they've also said that they need it to run on a Macintosh and Windows, and they don't even want the .NET framework installed. Well, that's going to be a little bit challenging. So fortunately, Microsoft has released Silverlight. In the Silverlight 4 development course, we'll walk you through the process of building line of business applications with Silverlight. It's a phenomenal framework, and especially once you learn the different fundamentals of it, you'll see how useful and easy it is to build desktop style applications. My name is Dan Wallin, and I'm one of the instructors and course authors here at Interface Technical Training. And in the Silverlight 4 development course, we'll walk you through everything you need to know to build successful Silverlight applications. So we'll start off with the fundamentals of the different Visual Studio templates that are available. And this includes things like the business application template for WCF Ria Services. We'll talk about the navigation template and why you might choose that over the standard Silverlight template. We'll also go into styles, control templates, and other technologies that you can use to totally take over the look and feel of your controls within the Silverlight application. From there, we'll really drill down into the key aspects of Silverlight for line of business apps, and that includes data binding. Data binding is where it's at, and bar none, that's probably my favorite feature in Silverlight itself. Once you learn the data binding and the syntax and how it works, you'll significantly reduce the amount of code you might traditionally write using other technologies. Once we get through that, we'll talk about how to get data in and out of your applications, and that includes covering WCF services, WCF Ria services, and how to make those types of calls asynchronously in your Silverlight apps. Now, it's one thing to learn how to write Silverlight applications, but it's another thing to build an application that can run within an enterprise environment. So we felt it was really important to cover the core patterns that you'd need to know, and that includes the MVVM, or Model View View Model pattern. We're going to talk about view models, service agents, binding techniques, and other things that you can do to make your code more testable, to make your code more maintainable, and so you can get better code reuse. In addition to that, we'll talk about out-of-browser techniques that you can apply. We'll talk about how you can even integrate with Office applications using COM Interop. And then we'll wrap things up by talking about some additional controls that are available in the Silverlight toolkit. So we have a lot of great stuff to cover, and by the time you get done with this course, you'll know how to build a solid Silverlight application, and I look forward to seeing you in class.